This is part three of rational exponents, and basically in this video I'm just going to do a variety of problems where we're going to use some of our new knowledge about rational exponents. Also, we'll be using some other laws of exponents, so here are some laws of exponents along with our two new ones for rational exponents. But any of these might be used. Most of these are common. You might want to look at this one here. If you have a fraction to a negative exponent, it's reciprocal to a positive exponent. A lot of people don't know that one. But most of these other ones are, you know, your pretty basic laws of exponents. All right, here are some problems for you to try. Use radical notation to rewrite the expression and then simplify if possible. So put the video on pause and try it on your own first. Okay, let's do this first one. Negative 4 to the 5 halves. The minus sign is not have anything to do with this exponent. So the minus sign's out in front. The base is 4. So I want the square root of 4 to the fifth power. So again, you write the minus sign. Now the square root of 4 is 2 to the 5th. You can keep the two in parentheses, but you don't need to. Just remember the minus sign is not being raised to the 5th power. And then we have to do 2 to the 5th, which is 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. That is 32. So my answer is negative 32. Next one. I have the minus sign in parentheses, so that's part of the base. The base is negative 36, so I want the square root of negative 36. But that's not a real number, so we just write it's not a real number until we do the problems where we learn how to do those kind of problems. Okay, next one. We have a fraction to a negative exponent, so that's the same as the reciprocal to the positive exponent. And now we have to raise both the numerator and the denominator to the 3 halves power. And I'm going to do a little shortcut here. That'll be the square root of 25 cubed. So I'm just going to write that as the square root of 25 cubed instead of taking two steps. And the bottom is the square root of 49 cubed. All right, so the square root of 25 is 5. And what's 5 cubed? 125. The bottom is square root of 49, which is 7, and what's 7 cubed? It's 343. Right, so that's 125 over 343. Right, next one. 2x to the 3/5 power. The base is 2x. So, there are a couple ways you could write this one. You could either write that as the 5th root of 2x cubed and stop right there, or because you can't really simplify that more, or you could write that as the 5th root of 2x cubed. Now if you wrote it this way, then you could simplify inside the radical, so that would be the 5th root of, well, this would be 2x times 2x times 2x. That would be 8x cubed. Which way do you think looks more simplified? I think this one looks more simplified. So that's how you might write that one. Okay, and the last one, 2 is not being raised to the 3/5 power. So we just write the 2 again. And then this is similar to the one we just did. This is x to the 3/5, so the base is x. So we could write the 5th root of x cubed will look more simplified instead of writing the 5th root of x and then putting a parentheses around and cubing it. All right, so those are just a few problems where you're practicing writing it in radical notation, and then if possible you're simplifying. All right, here's some more problems to try. Write with positive exponents and simplify if possible. So you might want to put this on pause and try it on your own first. Okay, for the first one, we have a negative 27 to the negative 2/3 power. So the base is negative 27, and I'm working with a negative exponent here, so I need to write this as 1 over, the base is still negative 27, you need that parentheses, to the positive 2/3 power. All right, now, what's this mean? The cube root of negative 27 Can you do that in your head? What's the cube root of negative 27? That's going to be negative 3. And then I'm squaring it. So negative 3 times negative 3 is 9. So I did skip the step of writing cube root of negative 27. All right, next one. X to the negative 1/6. That's simply 1 over x to the positive 1/6. And then we can write that as 1 over the 6th root of x if we want to write it with radicals. So both of these are actually correct. I didn't say you had to write it with radicals, but we did at least write it without the negative exponent. All right, the next one. 4 is in the numerator, and it's got a positive exponent that you don't see, 4 to the first, and same thing about 5. But x, that has a negative exponent. So I keep my 4 where it is. I keep my 5 where it is. But this x to the negative 1/2 means x to the positive 1/2 in the numerator. So I've now written it with a positive exponent. And you could further simplify this if you want by writing x to the 1/2 as square root of x. So this would be 4 square roots of x all over 5. Be careful that you don't try bringing the 5 up to the numerator. That's not going to work because it's really 5 to the first power, right? So there's no reason to move that up. The x is the base, so the negative 1/2 is the exponent only on the x. All right, last one. We've got negative 4 to the negative 3/2 power. All right, the base is only 4. The minus sign's hanging out in front, so I can just put that minus out in front. And 4 to the negative 1/2 means 1 over 4 to the positive 3/2. So I have a minus sign still. Now, 4 to the positive 3/2. Let's see if we could do part of this in our head. The denominator is the root, right? So we want the square root of 4, which is what? 2. And then we need to cube it. So we have negative 1 over 2 cubed is 8. And there we go. So those are our four answers. If that was the question that was being asked. How would we write 2x minus 3 to the 2/3 power in radical notation? Well, again, there's two ways of doing it. You can write the cube root of 2x minus 3 squared. That works. Or you could write the cube root of 2x minus 3 squared. Both of those are legitimate, but if you want, you could multiply this out. I'm not saying you necessarily would want to do that, but you might see it written out. 2x minus 3 times 2x minus 3 is 4x squared minus 12x plus 9. So really there's three ways you might write 2x minus 3 to the 2/3 power. All right, we're going to do a few more problems. Use the property of exponents to simplify and write with positive exponents. Here's the first one, x to the 3/4 times x to the negative 7/4. All right, now which law could you use there? You've got the same base that you're multiplying, so you add the exponents. So what'll that be? Well, 3/4 minus 7/4 is negative 4/4, which is negative 1, right? And how do you write x to the negative 1? 1 over x. Just a little review with exponents here. All right, let's try another one. X to the 3/4 over x to the 1/6. Right? How would I do this one? Well, just using our old friend where we subtract the exponents. All right, so we're going to have to do 3/4 minus 1/6. All right, now in order to do 3/4 minus 1/6, you need a common denominator. What's that going to be? You've got a 4 and 6 in the denominator, that's going to be 12s. So we know we're going to have to write each of these as 12s. So 3/4 is the same as 9/12, right? Multiply the numerator and denominator by 3. And 1/6 is, you can multiply the top and bottom by 2 so that you could write this as 2/12. So this gives me x to the 7/12. All right, you've just written it with a positive exponent. And you could also write it as the 12th root of x to the 7th. Both of those are correct, right? X to the 7 twelfths, or the 12th root of x to the 7th. Because basically, 1's in exponential form, but I've simplified it, and 1 is in radical form. Okay, that's all I could fit on this video, but we'll just do some more examples and more work with the laws of exponents and rational exponents on the next video.